Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil. In this video, I want to show you how you can perform 3D inspections. I'll show you how to inspect the IGT's overall conformity to the CAD and how to inspect surface defects. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. 3D inspections require optical 3D data. So I'll use a project containing a part with the CAD and actual mesh of the IGT and a suitable alignment. To check the IGT's overall conformity to the CAD, open 3D inspection in the workflow support and let's start with the surface comparison. It's used to compare the CAD to the actual mesh. ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil can display the deviations of the actual data to the nominal over all coordinates. To do that, use surface comparison on CAD. If you want, you can also define tolerances here. You can adjust the legend by clicking the upper or lower limit. Link the two limits to scale the legend symmetrically for positive and negative deviations. Red indicates that the material lies above the CAD surface. Blue means the material lies below the CAD surface. You can also create deviation labels to obtain discrete values. And check the minimum and maximum deviation. Now, just for your information, when you create a surface comparison on CAD, the software compares the CAD to the actual data and displays the result on a copy of the CAD. When you create a surface comparison on actual, it does it the other way around, comparing the actual data to the CAD and displaying the result on a copy of the actual mesh. For more information about the two functions, have a look at the tech guide. Okay, now let's take a look at the surface defect map. It allows you to visualize small local defects that are too small to be properly visualized with a surface comparison. In this case, I want to inspect surface defects on the concave side of the airfoil. To do that, display the CAD exclusively in the 3D view. In the 3D toolbar, use Select Patch and click on the concave side here. If you need help, look at the tooltip. Press Escape or use the right mouse button to close the selection. Now that we have the area selected, open 3D inspections in the workflow support and click Surface Defect Map. I'll name the element Surface Defects CC. Now, as you can see, there are two fields that need to be filled. The most important one is the maximum defect size. The value here must be bigger than the size of defects you expect to find. In this case, I'll use 2 millimeters. Under direction, select the stacking axis, so the z-axis of the component coordinate system. You can search the list here. Then click OK to create the surface defect map. To see the results, you need to display the actual surface defect map. The easiest way to find it is to look at the tab Relates To. Please note that the nominal surface defect map must be selected. Display the actual surface defect map and the mesh in the 3D view. And let's set the legend scaling to 0.015 millimeters. Now you can see the small surface defects. And you can of course use deviation labels to obtain discrete values. If you want more information on how to inspect surface defects, check out the Inspect Surface Defect Inspection e-learning. That's it for this short video. But just so you know, there's much more you can do with 3D data. Most notably, inspect the 3D throat area. If you want to find out more, take a look at the tech guide. If you're looking for a more comprehensive training, take a look at the Inspect Airfoil Optical 3D Data Basic e-learning. You'll find the link in the description below.